you will hear throughout today that part of the whole idea of the Criminal Justice Coordinating Council is not only diversion, but it's also looking at ways to be, should we say, more intelligent in how we deal with the total process from the time of arrest all the way through the time of the court proceeding into actually if, in fact, they come into an incarcerated system or come into some other type of diversion program.
You see the revolving door. Individuals who are arrested go out, reoffend, come back in, and in many times they're getting arrested while they're still awaiting their charges in the criminal justice system. The state implementation in the pilot project that we are trying to do is share success and share what works with other counties. So that each county doesn't have to go back and recreate the wheel.
25% of police calls for service involve persons that suffer from mental illness. If you suffer from mental illness, you are 16 times more likely to be shot by a police officer. Today, when there is a call for service in Janesville and a person suffers from a mental illness, there's a flag that comes up on the officer's computer screen. So they know that there's an issue there. And in many cases, behind that flag is a crisis plan. So when the officer arrives, he can look at the plan, and before he or she knocks on that door, they know what is probably going to work with this individual and potentially what will not work with this individual. Some of the anticipated outcomes of our project is less use of police force, fewer stays in the hospital with respect to mental commitments, reduced calls for service, better patient care, better patient outcomes, and less use of the criminal justice system.